Dating is weird. There's flowers, chocolates, and promises you don't intend to keep. But humans aren't even the weirdest when it comes to love in the wild. Hey lovers, Julia here for G News. To paraphrase the comedian Aziz Ansari, our courtship rituals are weird. I mean, if we like a person, we turn to them and say, hey, you know this hanging out thing we're doing? Let's do this until one of us is dead. Also, wear this piece of metal and carbon on your finger so everyone knows we have an arrangement. But we aren't alone in the animal kingdom when it comes to weird romance, oh no. In the wild, lots of times it's the male who's competing for female attention. Usually males strut their stuff by displaying colorful markings, performing fanciful dances, or even by fighting with another male. All to say, look at me, I've got the best genes, mate with me. But how does a pretty tail mean good genes? Well, sexual selection sometimes means the flashiest animal is the fittest. It's when animals evolve traits to attract a mate. I mean, take a look at the peacock, probably the most famous example. The males have these huge, pretty, but useless tails. They aren't good for anything other than putting on a good show, but the female peacocks think because this male is able to devote precious resources and time to a rather useless appendage and behavior, he must be in pretty good shape and have pretty good genes. Over time, many animals evolved a little oddly because of sexual selection. There's lots of examples of odd courting behavior in nature, but I'll just focus on my favorite three. There's the weird and wonderful hooded seal. For hooded seals, size matters. To entice a passing lady, male hooded seals inflate a giant red balloon-like hood out of their left nostril and wave it around. According to a study published in the Canadian Journal of Zoology, seals also use these hoods to produce calls and noises. Usually these noises are to ward off a potential adversary, but 12% of the time, they're to woo a lady seal. Besides the best call, the male with the biggest hood gets the girl. But if we're going to talk about sexual selection, we have to talk about birds. Birds, man, birds are the best at flashy courting. Similar to hooded seals, male frigatebirds, a tropical bird, have these huge red pouches on their chest called a Gular sac. During mating season, the sac is a bright red, and the males gather in large groups of up to 30 individuals. The females fly over the group, and the males inflate their pouches and use their beaks to drum on it to attract a mate. In a study published in the journal The Condor, researchers found that the drumming on the pouches helps tell the female about the size of the pouch, since the angle and distance she's flying might make it hard to see. Once the female picks her lucky guy, she swoops down and joins him. He takes her beak in his, and they walk off into the sunset. But my favorite courtship ritual might be the bowerbird. The males of this Australian avian build elaborate structures to seduce a female. Often the structure or bower is made of intertwining twigs and sticks. Sometimes the structure is in a little U-shape, sometimes it's in a little hut with an opening. And out on the front lawn of this little hut, the bird collects things. Lots of bright or shiny things. It's a garden of buttons or bottle caps or flowers. All this building and collecting takes up precious time he could have spent hunting or foraging for food, but the payoff is pretty great. A female bird will come and sit in his bower and watch as the male performs a complex dance. If she doesn't like it or finds him lacking in some way, she'll check out the bird next door. But sometimes the grass isn't always greener on the other side. She could come back. Once she checks out a few places, she picks the one she likes best. Picking the one you like best is always a hard choice, but the animal kingdom makes it a little easier with things like flashy tails. While we might not have a Gular sac or a nasal hood, there is always the tradition of giving jewelry. Speaking of, special thanks to K Jewelers for sponsoring this episode. For the bowerbird, every kiss begins with a button or a bottle cap. For us humans, every kiss begins with K. So courting is just the first step to making future generations of seals and birds, and every species seems to have their own strategy to making the beast with two backs. Some animals even mate to the death. To get the sexy suicidal scoop, check out this episode from Crystal.
Scientists at Queensland University of Technology say that these animals are biochemically driven to give it their all before, ultimately, the high level of testosterone triggers a malfunction in the inhibition of stress hormones.
So what was the weirdest date you've ever been on? Tell us about it down in the comments below. Don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons so you don't miss a single D News episode.